In this illustration, we'll analyze a white light on a thin soap film. We are given that a thin film of uniform thickness has a refractive index 4/3, and this film is illuminated by white light incident at an angle 30°. And the transmitted light is found to have a maximum value of intensity for a wavelength 7200 angstrom. And here we are required to find the minimum thickness of the film. So first, here we need to analyze the path difference of the light beams which will be transmitted through a thin film when the incident light is falling onto it at an angle of incidence 30°. Say, if the incidence angle is 30°, light will enter in the film at an angle of refraction r, and on the other face it is also reflected at the same angle r, and again it is reflected from the top surface, and finally it comes out in form of two beams from the surface which are at an angle 30° and 30°. So when these two light beams interfere, the light beams will have constructive interference if the path difference for the two beams in air is a multiple of lambda. Constructive interference will take place. Now, in this situation, first we need to analyze the path difference. So, if we mark this point as A, this as B, this as C, this as D, and we drop a perpendicular from this point D to the final emerging ray and say this is E. So, if we calculate the path difference for these two light beams, then we can see the path AB is traveled by both the beams, so we ignore it. For the first beam, it is coming out from this point, and the second beam travels a path BCD in this film which is having a refractive index mu, and finally it comes out at D. And if we talk about the wavefront of this beam, which is the normal cross section of the two beams, here we can write the path difference between point D and E can be analyzed as, we can write if this emerging beam 1 and this emerging beam 2, then the path difference between 2 emerging light beams is, this can be given as delta, and for the second we can write this path is BCD. So we write it mu times the path BCD. We are multiplying it with mu because the film is having a refractive index mu, and the optical path in air will be mu times the physical path traveled by the light in this medium, minus this path in air is BE. So if we substitute the values, if thickness of this film is T, then this path length BC can be written as T by cos R. So this path difference will be mu times 2T by cos R minus this path length BE, we can write this length multiplied by sine 30°, as this angle is also 30°, and this length will be 2t tan r multiplied by sine 30°. And in this situation, we can also substitute the sine 30 in terms of r, as here we can write by Snell's law, we use sine 30° is equals to mu sine r. So if we substitute the value over here, you can see this becomes path difference is 2 mu t upon cos r, minus this also becomes 2 mu t sine square r by cos r. And if we take this 2 mu t common, the result we are getting is 2 mu t cos r. This is the result which is quite useful for the path difference in the two transmitted beams when a light beam incident on a thin film at an angle of incidence I. So, in this situation, when this path difference is equals to n lambda, we can write the constructive interference take place. So here we can write when this is n lambda, this is for constructive interference. So we can write for minimum thickness of film, we use n is equals to 1, which implies we are having 2 mu t, the value of mu we are given as 4 by 3 multiplied by thickness t, we can write as t, which we are going to calculate. Cos r we can calculate from here as a value of sin r is equals to 3 by 8. So this gives us cos r is equals to root of 1 minus sin square r, that is root 55 by 8. So if we substitute the value, this root of 55 by 8 is equals to n, we can take as 1, and the value of wavelength is 7200 into 10 to power minus 10. And if we simplify this expression, the value of t we'll get is 291.25 into 10 to power minus 9 meter, or this 291.25 nanometer, that is a result of this problem.